Well, hello everyone. I am Brian Baxter, Quad City Symphony's Executive Director, and I'm very thrilled to be talking to you today a little bit about our upcoming Signature Series concert, War Reflections. It's our first of the year of this season, and it's kind of a big one. Personally, I'm very excited about it because it's actually my compositional debut here in the Quad Cities. One of the pieces on the program is a piece that I wrote. I'm not sure that everyone in town knows that I'm a composer, but that's my my side life when I'm not working at the symphony as executive director. So I'm thrilled to be sharing with you all a piece entitled Sentito di una Terra Distante. I heard of a distant land is what that means in Italian. And it will be paired alongside what I think is one of the greatest works in the chamber repertoire, Olivier Messiaen's Quartet for the End of Time. So it's a really exciting program, a lot of powerful stories behind it. So our season theme this year is the drama of the human experience, and it's all about stories, I think. And for me, music is about stories. And this program in particular, my piece was inspired by a story about World War I, and Messiaen's work is inspired by his personal experience during World War II. So two of the major conflicts of the 20th century, and different takes on different parts of how war kind of affects and influences our human experience. I'll talk about my piece first briefly. It's a piece about this Italian-American. He was a citizen. He and his family had moved here to the United States. They had become citizens. And he had left a woman behind who he had hoped to marry. And of course, the news of this war broke out. And he was probably 17 or 18 as the war was breaking out. And he was asking his mother to go fight for the Italians in the war. And of course, everyone is asking him, "You're insane, right? Like, you're an American citizen. There's no reason for you to go fight." But he, like many, have romanticized what war actually is. And wanted to go back and win the love of this woman, Elisa, who he wanted to marry. So eventually he broke through and was able to leave, and he fought in the war. Unfortunately, as we all know, the story of World War I is not a great one. It was very devastating, and his experience was very much like that. It drug on for a lot longer than he thought. He was able to meet up with the woman that he was hoping to marry, but they fell out of touch. He had gotten captured by the Austrians, and so at the end of it, he comes out of the war. He survives, which is incredible. He comes back after the war a changed man. He wasn't able to marry the woman that he wanted to marry, but he had his whole life ahead of him. So there's a bit, there's hope at the end of it. So it's this whole novel, which is documented by Marcy Mancodi. It's actually her great uncle whose story that I'm relating. She wrote this novel, in fact, about her great uncle's experience, and it's really quite powerful. She set it up like a play. So there's a bunch of acts, and for each scene in each act, she wrote kind of a fake aria. So she wrote the text, the libretto of an imaginary opera. For this short chamber work that I had been commissioned for, I decided to choose only six of these imaginary arias, and I packaged them together as a set of six songs. And so basically I took some of these arias and I created actual songs out of it. And I really focused on their love story. So the hero's name is Bernardino, and Elisa, I had mentioned, was his love interest. So it's a kind of a dramatic back and forth from the start of the war and the experience all the way until till the end, when he's looking back and coming back to what will be his new and changed life back in America. Now, to pair that with what I, like I said, is one of the greatest chamber works of all time by French composer Olivier Messiaen, it's kind of an honor for me because he's a great inspiration to my work as a composer. Quartet for the End of Time, if you don't know it, it's intensely beautiful. It's very colorful, very vibrant. He wrote it while it was after the Nazis had taken Paris, and he was put into a Nazi prison camp. And so he was writing this, if you can imagine being in Paris during World War II, the Nazis just took over Paris, like it would seem to be the end of time as you know it, wouldn't it? I mean, just like a stunning, stunning piece. And so it's his reflection on what the war means and how it's, you know, kind of just destroying everything across Europe. It's written for piano, clarinet, violin, and cello. And prior to that time, I don't believe there was a tremendous amount of repertoire for that type of ensemble. But because of the nature of him being in this prison camp, it was who was there and who he had around him. And you know, I can't recall the details exactly, but you know, they're playing on subpar instruments. He had to convince the Nazi soldiers to like just to allow him to put this together. And I believe they premiered it. They performed it in this prison camp, if you can imagine. Just stunning, stunning kind of experience there. So it's a unique instrumentation. And I would say that since that piece was written in the 40s, there have been many composers and works that have been influenced by this interesting combination of instruments, which I think works really well. Messiaen is well known for his deep, deep spirituality, and so there's a lot of religious imagery alongside of it, and paired with the colors of his orchestration. So there's not much more I can say about that piece beyond just you got to come hear it. So it's going to be a really, really exciting program. We're glad to be collaborating with the Rock Island Arsenal. So I hope to see many of you there and looking forward to it.